Good morning, guys, and welcome to day four of David Does Disney. We're over the halfway mark. Well done, everybody, for sticking around. This is a lot of Disney. But before I start today, I just wanted to get a couple of things off my chest. The first one is that a couple of people pointed out that when I talk about Ichabod and Mr. Toad, for some reason, I think it is pronounced Ichabod. Even though in the video before, I knew it was Ichabod, but I knew it was wrong. I was getting very, very confused with myself on that one. I'm easily confused. But yes, I've now learned the errors of my ways and can happily announce to you for the sixth time that it is called Ichabod and Mr. Toad and not Ichabod. And the second thing I just quickly wanted to mention was about my vlog yesterday. And I was feeling a little bit flat, and Lauren worked from home last week, which is great because I love spending time with her. And then always the first day that when she goes back to work, which was yesterday, I'm like, I miss her, and that doesn't help. And I've just not been getting enough sleep. Since I've started this, I've been getting up at before 5 a.m. and I've not been going to bed until at least like half one. And I just can't function on that amount of sleep, guys. It's just not doable for me anymore. But last night I went to bed at 10 p.m. and I woke up at 6 a.m. and I just feel great. I feel so much better, and I'm ready to like crack on with this challenge in a much more positive sense. So apologies about the third vlog. So today we are kicking off with Oliver and Company, which I've been told is supposed to be some sort of like toe-tapping New York smasher, which has got another cat in it and lots of animals, which, you know, there's always going to be a winner with me. If I saw a box of kittens, I'd take them all. How could you only take one? Take another one, please. So, Oliver and Company. Bit of a change in Disney movies with this one. First of all, the voice cast. They've got Billy Joel, Bette Midler, Cheech and Cheech and Chong, Dom DeLuise. This is the first film that I've properly noticed that they've used a like a celebrity voices. And then with that, if you've got Billy Joel, you're definitely going to use him with the music. And not only him, Barry Manilow helped make songs, and you can definitely notice a change in the songs. These are a lot more mainstream. But overall, Oliver and Company is just a retelling of Oliver Twist. It was fine. It was a cute little story. It's definitely not a major Disney film for me. I'm just going to go straight down the middle with it, a 2.5. But yeah. It was a nice little way to start the day. Some nice upbeat songs along the way. So the next movie is Little Mermaid, which done quite well for Disney. You may have heard of it. I'm not the Little Mermaid. Oh man, I wanted that little shell carriage when I was younger. It's so cool. One of the icons of the Disney villain world. She's frightening. Hello. I don't want to fall behind on my movies today, and I'm desperate for some breakfast because I'm hungry. So I've just brought my laptop out here, so I'm going to be making an egg bagel whilst I carry on watching The Little Mermaid. Back to the big screen with my breakfast. Uh-oh, sexy Ursula. It's really gross the way she busts out of that. And that's frightening as well. Little Mermaid. Yes, 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 yes. Love the Little Mermaid. 4.5 stars, easy. Great songs, great story, great characters, great villains, great sidekicks. It's just an all-round wonderful film. I did want to ask you guys something. For anybody who used to own the VHS of Little Mermaid many, 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 many years ago, at the end, there was like a little short story. It was like, it was live action. And it was a little boy who fell asleep and woke up and went on like a little adventure around, I think it was Disney World. Does anybody remember it? Because I tried to have a look for it on YouTube and I couldn't for the life of me find this video. But I'm sure he like goes up in a hot air balloon. And then, like, it's kind of like a flashback. He goes around all the rides on, like, Space Mountain and Phantom Manor and stuff like that. Am I just going mad if I made this up? I just remember at the end of the credits, they're like, and coming up is a special feature. Because also, back in the day, the VHSs, they used to play trailers at the end of the film as well as the beginning. So yeah, please let me know if any of you vaguely remember that. So I'm showered, cleaned, ready for the rest of the day. My Disney t-shirt today is another Mickey Mouse one. I pretty much only own Mickey Mouse t-shirt. So this one is a little bit of a creepy one. So you got all the parts there, you put them together, you make Mickey Mouse. Simple as that. So good morning so far. Really enjoyed the first two films. Next up is our first sequel of all of these movies, and that is The Rescuers Down Under. Now Bianca and Bernard are back, and they head to Australia to, I think it's find some sort of like big old eagle. Can't quite remember, but I remember there being some sort of issue with a syringe and the bird that flies them there, which I think used to give me the creeps a bit, but we'll see. So the bird in Rescuers Down Under isn't the same bird in Rescuers, it's his brother. I thought they were seagulls, but they're not. They're albatross. And the one in Rescuers Down Under is voiced by John Candy, which is so cool. Love John Candy.
Yeah, this is the bit I remembered. This is the bit that frightened me a little bit. Oh God.
I like the Rescuers Down Under. Bianca and Bernard, they saved the day again, as always. It's a fun film. I really think that Disney should have done, and possibly could still make it into like a TV show of them going around and solving crimes and mysteries, because they're a good little duo to watch. And especially in the Rescuers Down Under, they had another good set of side characters and another good villain. So I'm thinking, is this Disney's first film where they incorporated like 3D technology into a 2D film? Be interesting to find out if this was their first try, but they didn't want to risk it on like a big feature film. So they thought, let's just try it on The Rescuers and see how we get on. But no, overall, I'm going to give that a 3-star. Also, I've upgraded Little Mermaid from 4.5 stars to 5 stars because as I was writing the review for it on Instagram, I thought I really, really liked it and it deserves 5 stars. So there we go, I'm officially changing it. And next is Disney's Oscar-nominated smash hit, Beauty and the Beast. I think there might be another little 5-star coming up here. Answer me this, guys. This is too early for this like intro to have started. This come much later on, did it? I think, I'm guessing Disney has just put this in because they can. Yeah, see, and with this one as well. I feel like they, I don't know. Please let me know if I'm wrong. My favourite Disney song. And that man, my favourite Disney villain. Crazy old Maurice. That's my Gaston impression. Amazing, I know.
Crazy old Maurice.
See? You couldn't tell the difference, could you?
It was important, thank the Lord, that the napkins freshly pressed. With dessert, she'll want tea. And my dear, that's fine with me.
I couldn't help myself. 5 stars for Beauty and the Beast. Of course it was always going to be 5-star. I mean, how can you not? It's very similar in the vein to Little Mermaid in that it's just a great story, great characters, great songs. I mean, Beauty and the Beast, fantastic song. Gaston, my favourite song. And you can tell that, like The Rescuers Down Under, they yet again used 3D in a 2D film. So, Aladdin next. Potentially another 5-starer, and we all know who's in Aladdin, everyone's favourite sidekick, the genie. Do we all remember this level on the Sega Aladdin video game? Because I do, because I never completed it. It was so blimmin' hard. Is there anybody who doesn't like the genie? You won't be judged. I'm just interested, because I don't think I've ever spoken to anybody about this who doesn't like the genie. Oh, Aladdin, you little street rat. Saved the day in the end, didn't he, of course? But not 5 stars for me. Very hard though, it's gonna get a 4.5. Has anybody seen the Broadway or West End show. Lauren and I have seen the West End show twice and it is fantastic. The guy who played the genie is called Trevor Dion Nicholas. He's not the genie anymore, sadly, because he's now in Hamilton. But both times we saw it, he was the genie and he is worth the price alone. I don't know if he's still over in Broadway, but if he's in the West End and once everything goes back to normal, probably by next year at this rate, then definitely go and see if you can. I'm not sure who is playing the new genie, but they're not going to get a rubbish one.
She's just woken up, haven't you, Grumpy? I can't have another vlog without you in it, Minnie. You're the star of the show.
Lauren is on her way home, which is very exciting. But whilst I wait for her, I'm going to get started on The Lion King.
It means no worries for the rest of your days. It's our problem free.
I hope you enjoyed our little music video interlude there. That was good fun. What can I say about The Lion King that I haven't already said about Little Mermaid, Aladdin and Beauty and the Beast?
I know, Simba's sexy, that's what you can say. Particularly the bit when he takes the stick out of Rafiki's hand and puts it on the floor.
There you go. So another...
And when he goes over to check his mum's alright.
And when he... You did say you liked that bit, didn't you?
And at the end when he's going up the thing.
I think she's in love with old Simba. Before we get on to the next film, which is Pocahontas, Lauren and I are going to be starting to play a board game called... what's it called? It's called Villainous.
Welcome to Don't Let David Explain Board Games, because he makes them really, really confusing. We're going to play Disney's Villainous, which is actually what we got David's dad for his birthday. Everyone's got a different objective. You all play different villains from the Disney universe. David has opted to be Prince John.
Yeah, as he's now my new favourite villain.
I'm being Maleficent. And you all get different objectives and you have to play different cards and things like that. I can't fully explain what it's about because I haven't played it for such a long time, but we're going to give it a go now. There's a cauldron of power in the middle and we're going to crack on.
Oh,
I think it takes
a
bit of time.
Of power. Can't go down that far, so I'll just lift up the cauldron of power. It's got all these little tokens in.
I think we're just going to go for it.
Now that we are experts at the game of Villainous, we're going to carry on playing whilst we start the next movie, which is Pocahontas. Lauren's not seen Pocahontas, so I'll be interested to see what she thinks about it. I won!
David won. It's, I think the more we play it, the more we'll get familiar with it.
Yeah, definitely.
But I didn't love it.
No.
But I think that's because I love Hogwarts Battle so much. But yeah.
But I won because I collected 20 of these.
David's objective was collecting stuff. Mine was to get a curse on each time. There was a few times I was up to 3 curses.
Yeah. But then Prince John.
Prince John. Cheeky boy.
Cheeky boy. Stop chat.
Yeah.
So we've just finished Pocahontas. What did you think? Yeah, it was a little bit like
it's a bit
that.
Of a celebration of, and a bit of a romanticism of white people taking what isn't theirs.
Mm. True.
But I
don't
say,
go that deep, do I, in my reviews?
At the end, I thought she'd go with him, and then when she weren't going with him, I thought he'd come back and it'd all be lovely and there'd be like a montage. So it's quite a, it was an un-Disney ending.
True, it is an un-Disney ending.
I quite like the colours of it, but I think...
Do you like the colours of the wind?
I could paint with all the colours of the wind.
Oh, damn.
But I think in general, I'm not up for a romanticising of quite horrific behaviour. Oh yeah, God, I've got my glasses caught in my hair. that's the life.
Well, that's ruined your
chop me off a fringe in, there we go.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's how I felt. I've never seen it before, yeah. And I don't feel the need to see it again.
No, apart from those Colours of the Wind and Just Around the
Could
Room
Could you bend. At least try and fit my head in this video?
Well, it's because my head is so big.
Well, you should bend to me. You've got a big head, haven't you? Look at your big head compared to my little pea head. Yeah, it wasn't. I didn't think it was anything worthwhile.
No, and I think after the smash hits that I've seen today,
yeah,
it had to come to an end sometime, didn't it? Not that it was bad, but...
And the good thing is David is now going to stop filming and he's going to go and make me dinner and then we're going to watch an episode of Vicar of Dibley.
What would you give that? Well, yeah, because I've got to watch Hunchback of Notre Dame whilst making dinner.
Yeah, and then he's going to finish Hunchback of Notre Dame off after dinner.
She's telling me what I'm doing.
And then I'm going to bed after my dinner because I've got period pain and I'm hungry. Yeah. No, I'm tired.
Out of 5, what would you give it? Stars?
2.
2. I would probably give it a 2.5. So tonight I am making halloumi steaks with wedges. And whilst I'm making it, I'm going to be watching The Hunchback of Notre Dame. My last film of the day. Hunchback of Notre Dame, really good. Definitely not a film for kids, I'd say.
What do you think it was good?
Yeah, it was great.
Well, it didn't sound like you were enjoying it throughout. You kept saying how dark and nasty it was.
No, it doesn't mean it's... I just think it's not very... It's not one I would sit down with a 8-year-old child if I had one.
What are you going to get an 8-year-old child from?
I'm not. But yeah, I really enjoyed it. It was a great film. Poor old Quasi, don't have much luck. It's a sad movie and the animation is really good in this. So I think overall I'm going to give it a 4. Very good. Very, very good. So that's it for day 4. And we are now, 36 movies in.
Bloody hell.
I know. Tomorrow, another 8. So it's goodbye from me.
I don't get to watch Hercules.
You don't get to watch Hercules. That's Lauren's favourite movie. That's the first one in the morning. But you won't get to... Well, I mean, she could do. She could get up and watch it with me.
No, even if I did, I wouldn't be done in time to get to work. I'll watch it another time. Under less pressure.
Oh my God.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.